is it possible that the pressure that is on me, that God has allowed me to be in this situation? Isn't that right? Has he allowed it to accept God's will? Unless I what? Drink it. What does that mean? I've got to swallow this that God's actually in it. I got to give up my will. The step of letting go of your will and ways of accepting God's will in His ways. That's a huge step. We start moving to this step, we're moving closer to victory. Accepting God's will. And then he went away a second time and prayed. Jesus had to pray two times? What's his problem? He didn't get the breakthrough on the first go-round, huh? My Father, if it's not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done. Then he came back. And when he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went away once more. And prayed the third time, saying the same thing. Then he returned to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour has come, and the Son of Man is delivered into the hands of sin." The hour has come. He tried to alert them. They're not paying attention to Jesus. "Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer." While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived with him, a large crowd armed with swords and clubs. And we know what happened. But the battle was won right here. This is where the battles are won. Surrender your heart to God. Our hearts are strong and stubborn, and we not easily let go of their dearest treasures. We move ever so slowly to surrender. But here is the real battles of life. This is where the battle is fought and won. You pray until the job is done. And this is submission. It's really following His will and submitting to His will. And I've asked God to work His submission in me. It's submitting. It doesn't say you understand it. I think some of us want to understand. And that's when we get out. That's when we get all weird. It doesn't matter if we understand. It's clear Jesus didn't understand everything, or else he wouldn't be struggling. Effective prayer is having a conversation with God. And as you can see in this little illustration, Jesus was, "God, deliver me," and he turned around to the place of having a conversation with the Father. And you know what? This is your will. I just need to accept it. And I need to submit and walk under you. Even though it's not fair or right or good. During the days of Jesus' life on earth, he offered up prayers and petitions with fervent cries and tears to the one who could save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Son though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. If Jesus had to learn obedience through what he suffered, how do you think you and I are going to learn obedience?
Through grace.
What now?
Through grace.
We're going to learn obedience through the tough times.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Isn't that right, Glenda? Aren't you excited about this message?
I'm so excited.
Yeah, I can feel. When we struggle, Jesus himself comes to us by the Holy Spirit to strengthen us. In the Gospel of Luke, at this one spot where Jesus was in Gethsemane, it says that the angel came to Jesus and ministered to him, strengthened him. We need to pray. We need to push into God. Push. P-U-S-H. Pray until something happens. We need to push into God. We When Jesus told Simon Peter that Satan had asked to sift him as wheat, he said in Luke, "But I pray for you, Simon, that your faith may not fail. And when you have turned back, strengthen your brothers." I've asked this. I said, "Lord, what is the prayer you're praying for me?" Because Jesus is, it talks about in Hebrews that he is always interceding for us on our behalf. I said, "Lord, what's the prayer that you're praying for me?" That's given me insight. In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. "And he who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him." That's right after this. "To those who are called according to his purposes." The Spirit helps us in our weaknesses, and God will work everything together for good. If we have a conversation with God, if we're really walking with God. "For I'm convinced that nothing will separate us from the love of God that's in Christ Jesus our Lord." Nothing. But we don't feel that in the midst of pain. We don't feel that in the midst of struggle. Okay, so what? What does this mean? Talk to your neighbor and say, "Interesting message. What does this mean? What is God talking to me about?"